ጤና ይስጥልኝ ተመልካቾቻችን፣ ሳምንታዊው የውጭ ግንኙነት ፕሮግራማችንን ጀምረናል። ዛሬ ከወደ ሀገረ ስሪላንካ ይጃችሁ ልጓዝ ነው። ስሪላንካ ከህንድ ውቅያኖስ በደቡብ አማው ክፍል የምትገኝ ደሴታማ ሀገር ናት። እንግዲህ ስሪላንካ ከ2500 ዓመታት በላይ የሚያስቆጥር ታሪክ ያላትም ሀገር ናት። ይሄ የለበስኩት አለባበስ የስሪላንካ ባህላዊ አለባበስ ነው። ሰርግ ላይ እንዲሁም የተለያዩ ኦኬዥኖች ላይ ሲሄዱ የሚለብሱት ልብስ ነው። ሳሪ ይባላል። ከዚህ በመቀጠል አንድ እንግዳ ይዤላችሁ ቀርብ ያለው፣ እስቲ ወደ እንግዳ አብረን እንሂድና ቆይታ እናድርግ። እዚህ አጠገቤ የስሪላንካ አምባሳደር በኢትዮጵያ ውስጥ ክቡር አምባሳደር ሱሚት ዳሳኒያካ አብረውኝ ይገኛሉ። ከእሳቸው ጋር ደግሞ አጠር ያለ ቆይታ እናደርጋለን። በነገራችን ላይ ክቡር አምባሳደር የአገልግሎት ዘመናቸውን ጨርሰው ወደ ሀገራቸው የሚመለሱበት ጊዜ ላይ ደርሰናል። የስሪላንካ ኤምባሲ በአዲስ አበባ ውስጥ ከተከፈተ 3 ዓመታት ሆኖታል። ያለፉት 3 ዓመታት እንዴት እንደነበሩ ከእሳቸው ጋር ደግሞ አብረን ቆይታ እናደርጋለን። አብራችሁ ቆዩ። ቴንኪዩ so much for having this interview with me. Can you tell us about you know, your stay in Ethiopia? You've been here for 3 years now.
That's right, yes.
Yeah, how was it? Yeah.
Thank you very much for inviting me to talk with you. Actually, Ethiopia is a very lovely country. I came here very first in October 2016 to open the embassy because I was very much impressed by your weather and the natural beauty. That was my first impression. Then after that, within 100 days, we opened our embassy in Addis Ababa, for which I got very satisfactory support and courage, encouragement from the Ethiopian Ministry of Foreign Affairs and other government agencies, for which I must be very thankful. And also coinciding with the opening of the embassy, first ever official visit by a Sri Lankan foreign minister was also taken place on an invitation extended by your foreign minister. The Minister of Foreign Affairs of my country also visited Ethiopia. So on 2nd February 2017, the Sri Lanka embassy in Addis Ababa was officially opened by the foreign ministers of Sri Lanka and Ethiopia. So that was a very remarkable achievement.
Yeah, it is. You know, I'm thinking there's a very long history between Ethiopia and, you know, most Asian countries, and one of them is Sri Lanka. Why did it take this long? Why do you think it took this long?
Yes, actually, we established formal diplomatic relations with Ethiopia far back in 1972. Yeah. But due to various socio-political and economic reasons, we couldn't open the embassy up to 2017. So that is the reason. But at multilateral fora and other forums, Ethiopian and Sri Lankan political leadership and officials, they had very close and regular interaction. So that was very positive and very remarkable. And but our relations were intact, even though we couldn't open the residence diplomatic mission here.
What was the things that have been done in the past 3 years after you opened the embassy?
Actually, we did lots of things. First, we signed very formal agreements with Ethiopia when we opened the embassy. Then after that, lots of political, economic and trade activities were taken place. And also, you know that with the liberalization of your economy, and you opened up industrial parks, and your first industrial park in Hawassa was officially opened by your former Prime Minister Haile Mariam in 2017 June. So I also had the privilege to open 2 Sri Lankan factories with His Excellency the former Prime Minister at the Hawassa Industrial Park.
What kind of factories?
They are garment factories. They are in the apparel sector. But actually, one other important thing is when I came here, only 150 Sri Lankans were working in Ethiopia. Today, it has gone up to 800. Yes, now 800 Sri Lankans are working in Ethiopia. And most of them are working in the apparel industry. But some people are in other industries also. It is a very remarkable achievement, I believe.
Yeah, so what other engagements are they involved in, with Sri Lankan citizens in Ethiopia? Is it just the industry parks that brings them here, or is there other interesting and, you know, exciting, you know, things for them to come to?
Yeah, but rather than working there, working at industrial parks, some people are doing their own business also with their Ethiopian partners. And thank you. Some are actually enjoying your beautiful places as tourists also, but they are very much contributing to your economy, and not only that, they are training your personnel also. Sri Lanka is an island nation in the Indian Ocean, and which has a 2,500 years old history, and we are the first country in our region that liberalized our economy far back in 1978. So we started our first industrial park in 1978. So then we used to get lots of foreign investment at that time. So then we are the masters in apparel industry today. So then our people are very professional. So they are working all over the world. So lots of international companies, especially companies in the apparel sector, they wish to recruit Sri Lankans as managers. So that is an advantage. While working with them, others also, like Ethiopians, they can learn lots of skills which are necessary for them.
Yeah, the, you know, Sri Lankans, they have a very strong reputation when it comes to academia and education and stuff. Is there any, you know, opportunities that you provide for, you know, other countries like our country in Ethiopia, get a better education for, you know,
I like
Ethiopian
that question.
Yeah.
Thank you for that question. Because now every year we offer 100 presidential scholarships to foreign graduates, foreigners to go to Sri Lanka and learn. Last year, I think we offered 4 presidential scholarships to Ethiopian students, and they are now studying in Sri Lankan universities.
Okay, so that's being done through the embassy?
Yes, yes. Embassy coordinates with our University Grants Commission.
How do you send out the word? Like, how do you tell people that?
Because
this
now, once we, every year, these posts are being advertised.
Yeah.
So then we inform the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. That is our focal point here. Then they inform respective institutions. Then they choose these people and then send the applications to us. Then we send applications to our higher education ministry. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. So how about, you know, let's talk about culture.
Yeah.
You said that you know, you have been enjoying your stay here in Ethiopia, and I'm sure it's because you found something that makes you, you know, comfortable, and that's, you know, resonates with our culture. That,
yeah.
I'm thinking. So how did you find it?
Like, I think you have a very rich cultural heritage, because you are also one of the oldest civilizations. And I like very much your folk dances. I had the privilege to attend many state banquets and state dinners at presidential palace. So then cultural items were very attractive, very popular among foreign ambassadors. I also have enjoyed, and even your food also, very, very good.
Is there any cultural events that you have been having at the embassy?
Yes, now actually now, you know, as you know, this most of our Sri Lankan community is based in industrial park areas. So last year we had our traditional New Year celebrations at the Hawassa Industrial Park. So then lots of Ethiopians also who were working at the park came, and they enjoyed our traditional items. And in fact, I proposed, and actually it is being discussed still, to have a cultural cooperation agreement between Ethiopia and Sri Lanka.
Yeah.
Then with the conclusion of this, we will be able to exchange some cultural programs, cultural troops between the two countries. That would be a very remarkable thing.
How's the, you know, Ethiopian involvement in the Sri Lanka?
Actually, it is very, very small way, but some people go and do business. I have met very few people, but we want actually Ethiopians to come and work in Sri Lanka and come and invest in Sri Lanka. Especially I would like to invite, take this opportunity to invite Ethiopian investors, because lots of development activities being taken place in Sri Lanka. And now our southern port is being developed, and that area we are going to, we are opening a very big industrial park, and also other industrial areas also there. And in the Colombo port, we have a new business venture called the Colombo City Port, Colombo Port. Then that is also a very important thing. And so I think Ethiopians as well as other foreigners, foreign investors will get opportunities in the Colombo Port City project. Even tourism, we are the Lonely Planet selected Sri Lanka a few months ago as the best, that means number one tourist destination right, in the world. We are the number one tourist attractive place in the world according to Lonely Planet and a number of international agencies. So I invite Africans, especially African tourists, to come and enjoy Sri Lanka, because we have very sandy, very beautiful beaches, we have wildlife, and we have mountains, we have waterfalls, lots of things we can offer for tourists. And even in our country, it's a small country with 36,000 square kilometers, so then you can go to any place within 5-6 hours. So we have many climatic conditions, and come and enjoy Sri Lanka.
So it's really one of the top tourism nations.
Not one of the, it's the top.
It's the top.
Yes,
oh, that's
yes.
That's brilliant.
Yeah.
You know, I've made a little video before our interview.
Yes.
I've made a little video, and I'm gonna share it with the audience.
Yeah.
And I'm glad that you put some of your insights in there. After you leave, you know, the embassy, is there any future projects going on?
Yeah, there are a number of things are in the pipeline. One is now we want to increase our presence in Ethiopia.
Yeah.
And we want to do more business activities between the two countries. And there will be some exchange of visits, high-level visits between the two countries. And also, I had discussions with Ethiopian Airlines to have direct flights between the two countries. Actually, at the moment, our biggest problem is we don't have direct flights from Addis Ababa to Colombo. So then, if we can get that done, that will be a remarkable achievement for both the countries in terms of trade and economic development.
What about in terms of knowledge? Like, are Sri Lankans aware of, you know, our country?
After opening the embassy, I gave lots of interviews, and also the trade and development activities carried out by me was published in Sri Lankan media. So after that, there's lots of very, very high interest on Ethiopia by the Sri Lankans, especially the business community, because they want to come. And I want to add one thing. Last month, on an invitation extended by the regional government in Mekelle, Trigwe region. I was in that Mekelle region. So then there also, we went to see the industrial park in Mekelle. The largest garment factory is managed by the Sri Lankan managers. Yes. So their managers told me that Ethiopian girls working there, they learned the skills very quickly. That is an advantage you have.
Sharing experience.
Sharing experience and learning.
Especially in the garment, in the textile, you know, there's a big activity in Sri Lanka. So, this is your last year?
Last few days.
Few
yes.
days, yeah.
Yes, yes.
So, what did you take from Ethiopia? What are you going to say when you go back?
I learned a lot from this country.
Yeah.
And I think even in the political front also, and your Prime Minister, Dr. Abe, within few weeks after assuming office, he intervened to bring peace, durable peace, to African region, not only to Ethiopia, Eritrea, because he with the Eritrean leader he came to an understanding to end the 20 years long conflict, and as a result now he has been awarded this Nobel Peace Prize. That is the way actually, because we are also a country affected by a 30 years long civil war, so then I as the representative of the government, I salute your Prime Minister for his bold decision, not only to bring peace to Ethiopia and Eritrea, and he intervened to bring peace to whole mankind by ending this conflict. That is one thing. Second thing also, now this government has introduced lots of reforms, political reforms, and even now you are maintaining gender balance. That is something remarkable. And now your president is a lady, first time in the history. And I also want to add one thing. We are the first female prime minister was made actually. In far back in 1960, Mrs. Sirimavo Bandaranaike was elected as the first world female prime minister. So then Ethiopia also following. And half of your cabinet are now women. That is also a remarkable thing. And you have also established an independent election commission, and the elections is scheduled to be held next year. That is also a very good thing. And other thing also, that your government extended peace to all, not only one community or two community. As a result, political prisoners have been released, and those who were outside the country have also been invited to come. They have come. So I think now you are in a very vibrant democratization process. Also, we are a politically very much stable country, but that Africa, you are doing a revolution in Africa.
It is, yeah.
That is, you are teaching a lesson to the whole world. And other thing also now, you are also taking action to preserve the environment. And recently you initiated launched a project to plant millions of trees. That is the need of the world today. So I think you are addressing, and also your government is also spending, making arrangements to spend more on education. That is also a very good thing, because human development is the most important thing.
Yeah.
I hope that in very few years, within very few years' time, you will be a very successful story.
Yeah. You know, one of the things that that I know about Sri Lanka is, you know, there is a very strong women empowerment.
Yes.
And as you said, the first female prime minister
from our country.
From your country.
Yes.
And I've met with really strong females when I was back in college.
Yeah.
Very strong and intelligent.
Yeah.
Girls.
Yeah.
So what are the approaches that your country used in order to really bring women in these kind of, you know, big platforms? Asia and Africa, we have a reputation of women being, you know,
yeah, neglected.
Neglected, yeah.
No, because
culturally, even
culturally,
speaking,
but
yeah.
Now in our country also, several years ago, we had that problem. But actually, most important thing is now political will and political leadership.
Yeah.
So then with the appointment of first female prime minister from Sri Lanka, that was faded away. And also you in your country also now, you are in the process. Now you have appointed president,
yeah,
women president, and 50% of your cabinet ministers are ladies. So then I hope that gradually, these problems will be sorted out, and I can see now lots of Ethiopian girls are coming forward. They are doing government jobs, they are leading private sector organizations. Those are very remarkable things.
And leading the media as well.
Leading the media, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. So is there any last words that you have? Is there any message you want to get across?
Yeah, I want actually two messages. One, we want to see Ethiopia prospering. That is one thing. And we want to have more engagement with Ethiopia. And this is my second home. And I would like to extend my wholehearted best wishes and support to Ethiopia at present as well as in the future. at official level, private level, and at all levels. So last 3 years, your country gave me lots of experience, knowledge, wisdom, for which I am really grateful to my country for sending me, and also your country, Ethiopia, for giving me.
Oh, yes. That's wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Ambassador, it's an honor having you here. And we are very happy that you had a great stay in Ethiopia. And we hope that you have a very wonderful future. And thank you for agreeing to have this interview with me. And I hope that our relationships gets better by, you know, the next ambassador.
He will continue. Yes. He has to continue. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Once again, I enjoy your interview and your country and
thank
everything.
You.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. እንዲህ እያለን ወደ ፕሮግራማችን ማገባደጃ ላይ ደርሰናል። ዛሬ የወሰድናችሁ ከወደ ሀገረ ስሪላንካ ነበረ። ስለ አመጋገባቸው፣ ስለ አለባበሳቸው፣ ስለ ባህላቸው፣ ስለ ሴቶቻቸው እንዲሁም ደግሞ ከኢትዮጵያ ጋር የነበረውና አሁን ድረስ ያለውን ደግሞ ግንኙነታቸውን ስንዳስስ አብረን ቆይታ አድርገናል። ፕሮግራሙን አዘጋጅቼ ያቀረብኩላችሁ ኤግላይት ናይት ነበርኩኝ። መልካም ሳምንት።